So in the previous video, we have covered a different part of JavaScript tutorial, and I hope you enjoy the part in which we have learned how to logging into the console using login page in JavaScript. So today we are building a different part of the JavaScript video in which we'll be learning how to use Boolean values in JavaScript. And this video will be containing many of the important things, because here in this video I'll be telling you the basic Boolean values which we used in JavaScript. And like I'm telling you, we are doing all the project and all the part of the video project based. So this video will be also project based, and in this video I'll be telling you what the project we will be building that will helpful when you'll be moving forward. And remember to like this video if you're learning and it is helpful for you, and also subscribe on my channel. After subscribing, hit notification bell from which you'll be notified with all the future videos. Share this video so more people can learn and they can also take benefit of these amazing things like you are taking and you are learning things. So now we'll be starting with our video and seeing how we can build this amazing project and how to use things in that, like Boolean values and many other JavaScript tools. So like I've telling you, we will be just using an amazing tag of Boolean's values in JavaScript. So now, like I've telling you also, we are doing all the project based, and now using this amazing Boolean in JavaScript, we will be building a project of sticky navbar. Now if I just show you here in the browser, you can see this is my sticky navbar which I am building. You can see I am getting here my name, and at the top we are just getting the title of responsive sticky navbar. Then I am getting my name again. Then here we are just getting in shall written here. Then at the back we are getting a beautiful picture, you can see, which is looking awesome. At the right we are getting navbar menus on our amazing sticky navbar, like home, about, services, features, contact, and it is looking awesome. You can see all are getting hover effect, which is looking good. Then if I move down, we are just getting a thing. You can see this is the text written responsive sticky navigation bar on scroll, and then you will be getting all the amazing things down here. You can read these all things if you want to read. So here like this we are building this amazing responsive sticky navbar here. Now we'll be starting to build, and we will be using only JavaScript and Boolean values in JavaScript to build this amazing sticky navbar. So now we'll be starting and seeing how we can build this amazing sticky navbar. So here I will be closing this value. Now I've shown you what the project we are building. Here I will be opening in my default Google. Here I will be now closing. This is my file here which I have created. So here I will be only copying the starting code. Now close this file. Then you have to just do one thing. Here I will be now moving in this. Then when you've written this, here I will be deleting this file, because now I will be not needing. I will be creating my own file here. Now when you've created this, here I'll be pasting all the starting things. Then I will be now writing here only the title of sticky navbar like this. Now here you have to save this. Then I will be opening it in my default Google Chrome browser. Press Ctrl B to close side panel. Now here I will be opening it in my default Google Chrome browser to check it is working. So there it is. Open this. You can see all the things has been gone. It is totally empty, not containing anything. Now here we will be doing it side by side to see it is working or not. So here I will be doing it. Now here you have to do like this. Then when you are in this body tag, you have to do just one thing here. Like I will be making a nav tag. Here I will be class making of navbar. Right here div class. Then here I will be writing content. Then you have to write here div class logo like this. Now when you've written this, here I will be moving down. Then you have to write here a tag here in which I will be writing my name. Here you can write full name also. Save and reload. You can see we are just getting nothing here. You can see this. Now here when you've written this, we will be saving this. Then here you have to reload, and you can see we are just getting empty thing. Now when you are getting this, here I will be now making this file here. And now here when you've written these all things, I will be moving in this tag, and you can see we have written this. Now when you've written this, press Ctrl B here, and then when you've written these all things, here I will be moving down. Right here UL class. Then here I will be writing menu list like this. Now here I'll be moving down. Right here div class. Then I'll be writing here icon cancel btn like this. Save this. Then you have to reload, and you can see now we have to open this in our file. So here I will be moving in my main file here which I have created. You can see this is the file. And now when you are in your file, just you have to now take this file here, and when you've just done that, here I will be moving. And then when you've written these all things, here I will be now, just you can see we have written all this stuff. Now when you've written this, here I will be doing one thing. I will be moving in this. Then when you are in this tag, just you have to now do one thing. Here I will be now moving under this tag here which is written cancel btn. You can see this. Here I will be writing I tag, right class, fas, fa. Then here I will be writing times. Now you have to write li a tag. Then here I will be writing home. and when you've written this, here I'll be moving down, right here li 8 then here I will be writing about. Now when you've written this, here I'll be moving down, right here li 8 then here I will be writing services, then you have to move down, right here li tag 8 then right here features, like this. Now when you've written this, here I'll be moving down, right here li tag 8 right here contact, save this, reload. So here when you're getting these all things, now here I will be moving down, right here div class, and in class I will be writing icon menu btn, then right here I tag, right here class fas fa bars, like this. Now when you've written this thing, just here I will be moving under this left tag, right here div class banner, then here I will be now moving down, right here div class about, then you have to move down, right here div class, then here I'll be writing content, then right here div class title. Now when you've written this, here I will be now writing responsive, then here I will be writing sticky, or you can say sticky navbar in boolean using, or you can say with JavaScript. Now when you've written this, here I will be moving down, right here ptag, and then right here lorem ipsum here. Now when you've written this, here I will be just doing one thing, here I will be moving down, then after moving down, here you have to write lorem ipsum again, like this. Now when you've written these all things, here I will be just doing one thing, I'll be moving down after this div tag, right here script, save this, then reload, and you can see we are getting all this thing like I've shown you. Now here we are getting all the values like home, about, services, features, contact, inshall written. Then we are getting the text we have written, sticky navbar in booleans with JavaScript, like I was just showing you. Now when you are getting all this stuff, here you can just write here the codes which you want to write, and then here you will be just doing like this, save this, then you have to reload, and you can see we are getting all this stuff. Then we are just getting the title of inshall written, sticky navbar title at the top, at the back we are getting the image, and at the right we are getting home, about, services, features and contact. Then down we have do some of the change, here we have written sticky navbar in booleans with JavaScript. Then we are just getting the lorem ipsum here also, then down also we are getting lorem ipsum in a paragraph. You can write many of the text of lorem ipsum if you want to write, and like this you can build this amazing sticky navbar using booleans values in JavaScript. So like I'm telling you, we'll be working all the parts of tutorial in the project base. So this is our project base, and this is our part 12 for 11 which we are doing, and now I'll be moving forward doing all the doing more parts of JavaScript, and I'll be covering up more languages also in future which should be helpful for you. And I hope this video is also really helpful. If it is helpful and you are learning things from this video, so hit a like and also subscribe. After subscribing, hit notification bell and also share this video so more people can learn. So I'll be meeting you next project with more amazing things and more amazing tutorials. So for today, good. Bye.